ladies and gentlemen. Firstly, I will summarize shortly some key points what we know about reproduction and larval ecology of wendes. Corybos arzula. And wendes is small sized, obligatory plantivore fish species, which has communal pairs for small group of fish is mating near bottom in the dark, and occasionally pair of fish, female and male, rise up side by side, and in the end of this spawning rise, female releases small batch of eggs, normally about 20 eggs per spawning rise. And in the spawning grounds, egg densities are normally low. Meanwhile, in these lakes, it's about 8 eggs per spawning meter. They spawn in clear water lakes, deeper than in lakes with groundless water power. And hatching is well synchronized with the ice out. And usually we can find highest density of larvae in the neutral zone of the lakes. In our lake-wide spatial analysis, we aim to study more carefully where are larval wendes after hatching, and how large is differences in density between different sampling sites, are there more productive position near the hotspots, and how large is annual variation in density within a site or between sites. We had two study lakes, Konvivesi and Kuruvesi. They lived here. Our study lakes there. They are located in central Finland and both are oligotrophic lakes. Konnevesi has brownish water and Kuruvesi is a clear water lake. And especially Konnevesi has long broken shoreline and many islands. We have long term data available from those lakes. Annual larval samplings in Konnevesi for 19 years and in Konnevesi 21 years. And in 2016-2017 we carried out more extensive larval sampling program, several new sampling sites, and because normally annually we have 10 plus 20 basic monitoring or unit sites in the lakes. In southern littoral zone we use tube sampler pushed by a wader, and in the deeper than half meter old jet engine pole with onboard nets attached in the front of the vessel. This could be used also in the pelagic zone. In the spatial analysis, we used only data samples from the uppermost 30 centimeter layer. And this is because when this one we are after hatching positively photoactive, 90% of the larvae can our study lakes differ in proportion of littoral population, 92% of the eel has when they stayed after hatching in the littoral zone, while in the clear water lake. Although I see littoral percentage was only 25. Spawning grounds in Polo Basin is much, much more bigger than it has been in Polo Basin. We have got examples from both lakes in over 1,000 different sampling sites in Polo Basin. And only 4% in Polo Basin, only 4% of them was empty. No, we did not get any value. And in the Polo Basin, 15%. This is the data for in 10 years. 50% of them was empty in the lobby. Okay, I can say that we think that when they ask strategy to disperse their offspring widely all around the lake, and they do it already in spawn. And this dispersal we can solve also at larval stage. Here is 20 our basic or index monitoring station sites and data from for 7 years, 2011 to 2017. And red circles here indicate the years where larval density was 5, 6, or 7 times higher than the median value of the whole lake. And blue circles when the 4 times the larval density, annual larval density, was higher than the median value of the lake. And these red sites located in the middle of the Kondo Basin, quite near each other. And we can say that there are hot spots, more productive sites year after year. On the other hand, when we have a good year, there seems to be plenty of larvae in almost all sites. There is high larval population in 2016, black spots, surface here, and open spots 2017, which was low larval population here, 16 twice than the density that we recently. And for example, in the littoral zone, 70% of the sites, in 70% of the sites, 16, the density of larvae was higher than 70. And this we can see in all sampling zones, in shallow littoral, and pelagic zone also. And if we go our index monitoring station, the difference between years median values is exactly the same as then we use the whole 8 sites data. And this is same kind of view to privacy data. High and low year 2003-2007, high black circles, low purple circles, so you can see the same kind of the level increase. So it seemed that In high years, the density level increased almost everywhere in the air. So in summary, when they seem to have a productive strategy to disperse their offspring widely around the way, we find more productive places year after year, and then if there is years of high larval population, the density is increased almost every year. Thank you for your attention. This project is supported by EU project Press Rapid Life ID and Northern Savonia.
One more?